Hello! In my previous video tutorial, I explained how to prepare a development environment for Torino, which is a project I created using my web framework, Blackship, which is in Python, and React to build a single page application. So in this tutorial, I want to speak about using Azure Application Insights with Python for Python web applications. Azure Application Insights is a service to collect telemetries from apps, which in the case of web apps include information, for example, about how much time it takes to handle web requests, and also how much time is used to handle dependencies like connections to DBs, executing queries, etc. To make the thing even more interesting, I will show how to configure the API to use PostgreSQL instead of the table API in the storage account. So I have a instance of PostgreSQL server running on my local machine in a Docker container. If you want to know how to use Docker to run Postgres in a development machine in a Docker container, I recommend to read this article because it is very well written and clear. I will put the links in the description of the video. And I have also pgAdmin running in a Docker container. So I will create a new database for this tutorial. Now, of course, the database I just created is empty. It doesn't have any table inside. However, the solution I designed here is using Alembic and migrations. So it uses a code-first approach, and it will be very easy to create the structure that is needed by the API inside a new DB. So you can see migrations here. And now I will also show you how to create a SQLite database and then how to create the structure for Postgres. I will go back to the Visual Studio instance, which has the server. You can see under data migrations, I have the migrations which are necessary to create the structure of the database. And you should open the file named alembic.ini with the configuration for Alembic. By default, it has a SQL Alchemy URL going to a local SQLite database. So now I already created one, but I will delete it. So I don't have any SQLite database right now. I want to show you how to use Alembic to create a DB from scratch. Here, I have my virtual environment already from the previous tutorial. I will use the command alembic upgrade head. What will happen? It will create a new SQLite database with the right structure. Now, you can see that I have this file TorinoDB, and I can open it with the DB browser for SQLite, for example, to inspect its structure. And you see we have albums, nodes, and storages already ready to use. To run the same migration on the PostgreSQL database, I will need to modify the connection string here for the Alembic. And I have an example here. In this case, I'm using PsychoPG driver. In my case, I have a username Postgres with password Postgres running on my local computer, and the database name I just created is Torino Demo. So when I run again this command, it will create the structure database structure in my Postgres DB. Let's see, schemas, tables, and here they are. You have albums, nodes, and storages. That's everything we need to handle the virtual file system in Torino. Now I will also reconfigure the API to use the PostgreSQL database instead of the table API, which is convenient because you have more features in the future. We can add the search by like, and also, for example, statistics about how many nodes are configured in the virtual file system. Here also I have an example. We will just correct. These parameters and the name of the DB. Note that in this case I'm using a different driver, async PG, when I'm running the API. And to make things slightly differently, I will this time start the API this way. Note that it's a bit slower because it is also touching the debugger in this case. So if I go back to the SPI I showed in the previous tutorial, which is running on the Webpack development server, you will see first that I don't have any album, and because of course I just created a DB, and I can create a new one here. This time, the album was created in Postgres. You can see that I have here an example. The system is also configuring slugs because in the future I expect it should be possible also to use slugs to navigate to the album. Now, let me configure an Azure Application Insight service and show what happens when I enable it on the API. We go here. And for this tutorial, I will create the service by hand. Usually, I would use a bicep template to create it, but for the sake of this demonstration, I want to make it by hand. We will do create in the right subscription resource group, of course. I will choose Western Europe data center, and I will leave it enabled as a workspace base because it's a new way of working with application insights. The name I will call it Reno Demo App Insights. You see now the deployment started. It will take some time, but not much. Depending on the server, the deployments take longer or less. But application insight is generally relatively fast to complete. Once the deployment will complete, I will obtain the instrumentation key of this application insight service, configure it in the application settings of the API, and restart the API. Then after playing a bit with it, we will see that telemetries are collected by the system and sent to Application Insights. This very, very convenient way of working when deploying web apps in Azure. And the deployment succeeded now. So I can go to the resource. And you can see here you have some summary like failed requests, server response time, server requests, availability of the service, and performance metrics. To configure it, in the API, all I need to do is only go into overview, copy the instrumentation key, and putting it as a monitoring key of the service here. Then, just to give you the full context, logs are configured in the app logs. So here it is configuring the logging for the logging framework, so the built-in logging library in Python. It is also modifying how the SQL Alchemy entries are logged, and modifying the application to automatically collect information about each web request, even those that are failing, and send information to Application Insights. So, since it will be a bit faster, let me start the application this way. You see this time it's not logging that Application Insights is disabled because it has a monitoring key. Let me go back here to the front end. Here I will create some folder. I will upload some files. The same file that I uploaded in the previous video. Yeah, all files were uploaded. I will copy some of these nodes. Refresh a few times. And now, at some point, I should see some information here in the dashboard. Imagine you are navigating back to the same page. And you see here, I have already some information about the server response time and the amount of requests, 49. And you see here, it's very interesting. It is showing the request organized by routes, methods. It also includes the options request, which is used to handle the cores request from the single page application to the API. And if you go under dependencies, you will see the various things that are happening to handle the web requests. So you have the queries executed by SQL Alchemy, organized by query. So it's quite convenient to see which are slow, which are fast. You have also the process image, which is the part that is resizing the pictures, which of course it takes some time. And how this is achieved, the organization by SQL query for SQL Alchemy is obtained by this code, which is configured as a telemetry processor. The integration with SQL Alchemy itself is configured somewhere. I don't recall exactly where. Let me find it. So I just need to look for trace integrations and I will find it. Yeah, it's happening here in the init file of the SQL namespace. So this is everything you need to integrate Application Insights with OpenCensus and SQL Alchemy. This is amazing from my point of view. I only needed to study a bit about how to organize the logs by query, because from my point of view, it's more interesting than having a single bucket where everything is put behind. For SQL Alchemy. And something that is also interesting, how do you do custom collection of telemetries like this process image. So you can achieve this easily with Python thanks to function decorators. Let me show an example here. Here, under the domain, I have this context manager defined. And this function, which is a decorator. All you need to do is to use this decorator to collect information about a certain dependency. In this case, you were seeing process image because it is decorated this way. So every time it is called, it adds an entry to the logs for application insights. I had to study a bit before being able to use these things in Python because you need to understand how they work to use them. But now I feel I have much more control than in other situations where things happen automatically without my knowledge. And if you use also the application insights JavaScript library configured in the single page application, which I didn't configure yet, you can also get information about page load time and everything that happens from the user perspective also on the client side. But it's something very interesting from my point of view, and I wanted to speak in a video tutorial about these things. So thank you for listening and have a nice day.